gets this great feed from Keith Jennings to Talford for the dunk.
Look at Talford. The beauty of the pass, as you mentioned. Look at the timing. That's a piece of video he's going to want to keep, huh?
He Calvin really Talford. He really is a great athlete. Buzz Peterson, who's an assistant coach at East Tennessee, last year when he was at Appalachian, said Talford one of the greatest athletes he's ever seen, and that is quite a compliment considering his former roommate at North Carolina was Michael Jordan.
That's right. And Michael turned out to be a pretty fair player himself.
I'd say so.
Buzz was talking the other day to me about Michael Jordan's golf game keeps getting better and better and better.
Michael knows golf, right? That'll be the next thing, right? Another two-sport guy. I really have to admire guys like that that can excel not only to that level but in so many different sports, like Jerry Valancourt. There are the numbers on Damon Williams yesterday. 20 points, 5 assists. Great game.
Yeah, if you saw me playing golf, I'd get arrested.
6:54 to go. It's a 4-point ball game. Already 13 for Damon today. Got a pair. VMI just not going to let go. They're going to hang on to the end here. And if they're still in it, they got a great shot to win. They got a great team. Dennis. Oh, what a play by Greg Dennis.
I'll tell you, 6-11, takes it to the basket. Got the offensive foul. You like to see those type of floor skills from a player that size because you hope down the road you slide him to the small forward position if he has any options to play in the NBA. Here's a look at it. Good call by the official. Kraft went up. There was no body contact coming from Mark Kraft's side, but VMI did an excellent job. Feet were stationary. It was there. Les Robinson doesn't agree. But then that's his job not to agree.
They even disallowed the bucket. It's a 3-point game.
I like the stuff VMI runs out of their half-court sets. Let's see what they do out of here. Baseline screen. It's in.
Damon Williams with 17 big ones already. We got 6 minutes, 25 seconds to go in the first half.
Well, you can't trail cutters through the lane because if you don't, you get beat. If you do, you get beat.
Dennis threw it away. Kraft down, no call, but VMI gets the ball back and a chance to take the lead again.
And that pass hit the back of the backboard on the inbounds on this end.
Should have been out of bounds.
That's right.
Lennon Mee misses the shot. Kraft and Keller, there's a real match, but Kraft gets the foul, his second.
You like the way these two guys are challenging each other down low. Somewhere along the line in a close basketball game, a matchup develops where someone gets the advantage and it generates who wins the basketball game. You've got Kraft rolling to the baseline side, both going up. I don't see where that was a foul. How come you never say anything?
Because you do it so well. Keith Jennings misses the shot. Raymond gets the rebound, but stepped on the line first, and the Buccaneers get it back. I mean, face it, Jerry, how can I add anything when you say it so well? Buccaneers will inbound. Major Gear will make the inbound toss. Inbounds it comes, Keith Jennings. Gear was open momentarily, but somebody you don't want to let.
Tough pass, he threw it behind the cutter.
Covington tripped from behind. Here's a steal by Damon Williams, who has done absolutely everything in this game for VMI.
I'm not going to be tempted to fall into cliches when you say he's done absolutely everything. You know, you come back and say, what, he's going to go to the concession stands? But he has done it all. He's coaching it on the floor. He even passes up shots and does a nice job of spreading the sugar, as they say.
He misses this one. Lennon Mings is going to be charged with a foul. Over the back, trying to keep the ball alive.
Here's a look at it. Nice play action by VMI. One of the twins comes off the baseline screen. Over the back. You know, give a lot of credit to Mark Kraft and Mings in creating openings for the twins because they set some excellent screens down along the baseline.
We're in the 1-1 for East Tennessee. We go to the other end and we'll shoot that bonus situation. Calvin Talford at the line. There's Joe Contapio.
What a coach he is. Excellent coach at one of the toughest coaching jobs in the United States at VMI. He could coach at any Division I program in America. Thoroughly convinced of that.
Talford gets the bucket.
Along with Les Robinson. Lewis Preston, 42 at 6'7", comes back in the game. And in the earlier moments when he came on the floor, did a nice job on both boards.
8 points for Talford today. Give him, well, he almost got it. Kept alive, saved by Covington. VMI gets it. They're down two as we go under the five-minute mark now in the first half.
Nice patience as they look at their cutters.
Damon, nice fake. Raymond misses. Preston, nice follow by the big Preston.
That's a nice job on offensive boards. Had some good moments early on.
Talford gives the feed to Story, rejected by Preston. Tell you, that freshman came to play today, too. Here's Raymond. Missed it.
Preston again.
Raymond again. Yeah, he got it.
I am a great shooter. Did not hesitate at all to pull the trigger once again. And Preston, three excellent trips coming off the bench for the freshman. Triangling two.
VMI by three, following the three-pointer by Raymond Williams. Here's Jennings. Talford missed the three. And Story, to get position for that rebound, was pushing.
I'll tell you, there's some eye-popping execution going on both teams. Play action with their set offensive sets. Look at this set here. Got a jump shot off the back. Watch the push off. Well, it came just before the rebound.
3:49 left to the half. VMI has the ball and a three-point lead. We'll be back.